how to update Adobe CS5 plugins. Today we're going to learn how to update those Adobe InDesign CS5 plugins, but first of all, what is a plugin? Well, we read here, the InDesign plugin modules are software programs developed by Adobe Systems and other software developers, third-party software developers, working in conjunction with Adobe to add features to Adobe software. A number of importing, exporting, automation, and special effects plugins come with your program and automatically are installed in the plugins folder. Let's go look at that over there in the Adobe application folder right now. Okay, so on this Mac here, we're in the applications folder, and I can cruise into Adobe InDesign CS5. And inside Adobe InDesign CS5, we see several folders, one of which is the plugins folder just mentioned in the help page on the adobe.com site. So if we click on this plugins folder, once again, we're in CS5, the CS5 plugins folder, we see inside of there several different subfolders. So how do we get third-party plugins? How do we add features and functions to Adobe InDesign without bugging Adobe themselves? Let's go check that out. Okay, I'm over here at a third-party developer for Adobe CS5 plugins called Markzware, markzware.com. And we make several plugins and extensions for InDesign and other DTP applications, Quark, Illustrator, Photoshop, etc. We cruise on into one particular Adobe InDesign CS5 plugin, which is Q2ID. We can there read that Q2ID imports Quark files into InDesign. It'll open Quark files in InDesign. So this is a very handy CS5 plugin. So we can buy that now. And once we get this product, we'll install it and show you how it looks inside the Adobe CS5 plugins folder. Here's an example of an Adobe InDesign CS5 plugin. You see the .InDesign plugin gives it away as a Adobe InDesign CS5 plugin in this case. We see different versions of InDesign plugins as well. Let's go add this into our InDesign folder under the plugins and the filters folder and see how that works. Okay, so now we've added or used the third-party developer's installer to install the plugin. And in this case, we'll go under filters in the plugins folder and we'll see in there several other plugins. And you'll notice they all have the .InDesign plugin extension. And you'll see that one of those is the one we just showed you from Markzware, the Q2ID version 5.5 plugin for CS5. And this plugin will now show up within our Adobe InDesign CS5 application. So that is how you can update Adobe InDesign CS5 plugins by simply reinstalling a version of that plugin. In this case, we did a fresh install. All right, how does it look inside InDesign? How does this update of Adobe InDesign CS5 plugin look once we've launched Adobe InDesign? Let's go check it out. So here we are with an InDesign, and where you will see updated Adobe InDesign CS5 plugins, or where you newly install them, really depends on the manufacturer. InDesign CS5 plugins can be built in to work in the background with an InDesign. Markzware, in this case, adds a Markzware menu item up top in the InDesign menu item. So you see this updated InDesign CS5 plugin shows up right within InDesign. All right, everybody. This has been the how to update InDesign CS5 plugins. I hope it's been helpful. It's quite a simple process. You just simply must go to the developer or to Adobe's webpage and find the updated version of that plugin and basically generally do a fresh install or update or reinstall the plugin. Plugins are very useful and can help you enhance Adobe InDesign incredibly, saving you even more time and money. This is David Dilling from Markzware on how to update Adobe InDesign CS5 plugins.